After the mapping, what is generated is what is called a sum or a BAM file. And I've already shown you. So these files, that they contain the information from the FASTQ file and extra information on the mapping. Okay, what are they? So sum files are text files. You can open a sum file on your computer in a text editor like WordPad or Notepad, and you can take a look. If they're not too big, you can do that. So you can read them. It's basically a tab-delimited text file. It has a lot of information. For a full description, you can take a look here. I'm not going to go into detail here. I do want to mention that they contain a header part, and you can recognize the header because all the lines will start with an at sign, and the header contains information about the mapping. So which reference was used, which mapper was used, what were the parameter settings of the mapper, and that kind of information. It's in the header. And then after the header, you have the actual alignments. What do the alignments look like? You can find them here. So this part, I've already mentioned it previously. This is the part that tells you the information of the mapping. What do you see here? Well, you will get a name for every read. So that's still the location of the cluster on the flow cell. You will get a flag that tells you more about the details of the mapping. I will come back on that. You will see where the alignment starts. So this starts on chromosome 20, position 7. You will get a quality score for the mapping. And this is a score that you interpret in the same way that you interpret the base quality scores. So 20 means 99% confident. And then you have the cigar string. And the cigar string represents the actual alignment. I will come back on that. First, the flag. So flags are always numbers, like 163. What does it mean? Well, there is a tool from the Broad Institute, a website, where you can type in the flag, and then he will tell you what it means. So every flag has a special meaning. So this one, 163, means this was paired end sequencing. The two reads could both be mapped. They could be mapped in each other's vicinity and on opposite strands. That's what 163 means. So that's a good one. So all these flags have a meaning. Now, of course, you're not going to look it up for every read in your file, but all the downstream tools, so the tools that are going to work with the mapping results, well, they will look at the flags and at the mapping quality and at the cigar strings. So that's the information that they will look at to process the mapping results. So the cigar string, what's that about? So that's actually quite cool. So when you do an alignment, you will typically see something that looks like this. Yeah, in the BLAST, for instance, when you get your results back, the alignments look more or less like this. Eh? Now, you cannot include that in a sum or a BAM file. These files are already so huge, if you're going to include this, they will be enormous. You cannot do that. So instead of including this in your BAM or your SUM file, you're just going to represent this by the cigar string. How does it work? Well, you have your reference, you have your read, you know the sequence of both. You know that the alignment should start on position 7 on chromosome 20. So let's assume this is chromosome 20, position 7 is here, so you know that the alignment has to start here. And then you can read the cigar string. So there are 8 matches. That's this part. So where the two sequences are written underneath each other. And it's called matches, but it can also be a mismatch. There can be a mismatch here. There is. That's not an issue. It's called matches because they're underneath each other. Then you have 2 insertions. These are gaps in your reference. Then you have again 4 matches. Then you have a deletion, which is a gap in your read, and then you have again 3 matches. So using this and this, you can completely recreate this alignment. But this is, of course, much more compact than this. So this is what the cigar strings mean. So you can easily see that if you want to know information, how many errors were there, the total error rate in your mapping. Of course, the tool who is going to calculate that has to go here, has to use the cigar string for that, because then he knows where the insertions and the deletions are, for instance. So these cigar strings are really important. So, what if the mapper has done soft clipping? So I told you last week that when you use RNA-seq mappers, you typically are not going to remove low-quality bases from the ends of your reads. That's not necessary. Why? Well, because the RNA-seq mappers, they do soft clipping. They ignore mismatches at the ends of your reads. They're just not counted in the alignment. They're not included in the alignment. So when a mapper does soft clipping, you will get in your BAM or SAM file a line that looks like this. So let's take a look here. So this is your read. This is your reference. It's again chromosome 20. So start here, chromosome 20. What do you think will be the begin position that is mentioned in the BAM or the SAM file here? So he's doing soft clipping here. So this is an RNA-seq mapper. He's going to map here. And you see that the first three bases, they're written in small letters, they do not match. But since he's doing soft clipping, that's not an issue. So he's just ignoring them in the alignment. And this is why the alignment with soft clipping will start here. These are soft clipped, and this is where the actual alignment starts. So it will be 9 in this case. And then here in the cigar string, you can see the 3S. That means that the first three bases of your read are soft clipped. That's what S means. So 3 soft clipped, and then we have 6. What will be the letter here? 6 what?